Success Connection on BCTV is supported by the Kutztown University Small Business Development Center.
Good morning. I'm John Merlino, a graduate assistant working for the Kutztown Small Business Development Center. Today, we have Nicole Vasquez from That Shuu Girl Boutique, which is on 147 East King Street in Lancaster. Thank you, Nicole, for coming in today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. So, Nicole, let's tell us everybody a little bit about yourself.
Well, obviously, my name is Nicole Vasquez, and I'm the owner of That Shuu Girl Boutique. We opened about 5 years ago. Originally, I was a nurse, but I always felt like there was something missing in my heart. Prior to being a nurse, I was always a stylist in school, always made our own clothes, mine and my sister's. And then everyone would always come to our house and ask me to style them for either prom or homecoming, or maybe there was just a party we wanted to go to, so everyone ransacked my
closet.
Yeah, so that's when I started to fall in love with fashion. And after school, I used to do a little fashion gigs here and there, working with models and working with other businesses to do some styling with them. And
so it's like, it's been a passion since you were young.
Yes.
And you've been building it up. And then you worked in nursing for a few years.
Yes.
Thought that was the way to go, but then realized you'd rather help people and, you know, picking out their facade rather than fixing their insides, right?
Yes. I'm just a person, I love to help and I love to give back. So nursing is what I thought I wanted to do. And like I said, I always felt this emptiness in my heart that, you know, I love this, but there was something else that I should be doing. So when I opened my business, and I was like, this is where I'm supposed to be. This is where my heart is.
So for those that you don't know, That Shuu Girl Boutique, you sell clothes and jewelry and other kind of accessories.
Yes.
Tell them a little bit more about that.
So That Shuu Girl focuses on American-made clothing. And we also focus on clothing that give back, so like a social enterprise. We have a girl, a local girl in our store named Timbrell. Her brand is called Lush Bazaar, and she goes back and forth to India, and she creates jobs for the impoverished women and men out there. So that's what our store stands for. Our store is a showroom for independent designers like myself to showcase their passion and their designs. So we try to stick with American-made, local. We have a lot of local designers in our store, and that's just what my passion is. I love to help other people, and I want them to have their stuff in our store.
So it's like all around, you're really building the community, right?
Exactly.
And you're taking a step away from what has been the status quo for many years, right?
Yes.
The cheapest price, everything like that.
Yes.
Now we're looking towards giving back and making sure that the artists at home are getting retribution for the things that they do.
Yes.
And I've been to our store, and some of the stuff in there is really gorgeous, from the handmade jewelry and just to the clothes. It's really incredible.
Yes.
So how'd you come up with the name?
So That Shuu Girl, stemmed from my childhood.
Okay.
My sister and I and just a few friends, we always used to put fashion shows together, or just like, you know, we get dressed up, we used to always like, Shuu Girl. So Shuu Girl is basically means you look nice, you look stylish, you are That Shuu Girl.
You're That Shuu Girl.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, because that's exactly what you have. Everything's
yes.
So stylish. And what made you decide Lancaster? Are you from Lancaster originally?
I'm born and raised in Lancaster. I don't know. I feel like King Street has a sentimental value to me. We grew up on King Street, on top of Rick's Place. We lived there for many years. And then my sister and I moved a block up from where my store is at. After we moved out our parents' house, we lived there for a while. We used to always go to Red Rose, always go to Market. So it seems like King Street has my heart since a young girl. So my fiance actually is the one who found the storefront for me. I always told him I always wanted to have my own boutique. I wanted to have my own designs in there. I wanted to support other independent designers. So one day he surprised me. He told me he was taking me out to eat. And he had made an appointment with our landlord. And it was that spot. And as soon as I walked into my store, I felt the positive energy. And I knew that was a store that was for me. Yes.
And it does definitely, you know, Lancaster has such a cute, like, cozy vibe, and I think your store fits right into it, right?
Yes.
It's like you walk in, it's the old wood, it's like the old style still.
Yes, we wanted to keep as much as original in that store as possible. Prior to me having that store, it was a laundromat. So if you look on our floor, not only did we paint it black and have glitter on it, there are patched holes from all the washing machines that were in the plumbing and everything. So we have all of that original feel in our store still.
Yeah.
We didn't want to change we wanted to keep as much as possible in our store.
It just adds a more unique feel than the clean cut that you see everywhere else.
Yes.
So you grew up in Lancaster. How have you seen Lancaster change over the years?
Oh my gosh. Like I said, I grew up in Lancaster on King Street. There was only downtown was only like King Street and a half of Queen Street. So just like that L there, growing up when I was, growing up, my aunts and my mom and everyone say, when they grew up, it was a vibrant downtown. But when I grew up, I didn't see that. It has changed a lot. There's so many beautiful boutiques. There's so many good restaurants. It has redeveloped amazingly. Yes,
it
has
really come back. And That Shuu Girl fits right in between.
And That Shuu Girl fits right in.
Yeah, because I always feel like, you know, what's up in Lancaster when we go there, all the things that are coming in, all the new places that are opening up, and I feel like Lancaster in itself has a lot of programs that help entrepreneurs take their first steps.
Mm-hmm.
Besides the SBDC, because we'll get there, what other assets have you used that were available?
There's the Women's Business Center and with assets is a Women's Business Center. So they help not only women, they help a lot of individuals who are starting small businesses and who don't have the resources or don't know about a lot of resources. Assets helps with that. There's community first funds that help with a lot of small businesses who need funding. They help with a lot of startups, and they continue to help. Lancaster City Alliance is another great organization that helps with marketing the downtown Lancaster to bring people down here and down to Lancaster, and they also help with a lot of small businesses.
I think that's really important, and I think that a lot of people sometimes they don't realize how many resources are right there at their fingertips, almost low-hanging fruit for them to use to help them take those next steps, because I think one of the things that always holds people back is a lack of knowledge or information.
Exactly.
So I think, I was able to go to Cultivate Lancaster a few months ago, and it was really amazing the amount of people and the support, really, that was there for people to take those first steps in starting their business, because we get stuck in our lives and I think it's the status quo, but just a little push and you can be doing the things that you always like to do.
Exactly. And I just always tell people, because they look at me as an inspiration, and I'm like, look, do what's in your heart. If you feel as though you have a goal and a dream, follow that. Don't ever let anyone tell you you can't do it, because some people get discouraged, and it can be the littlest word that you say to them, and they get scared, and they don't want to follow their dream. So I always tell people, and I love to mentor the young women out there, our next generation. I always go out and I talk to them, and I'm like, if you have a dream, make sure you follow it. I don't mind helping wherever I can to, you know, get you to the next step, to opening a business, or maybe it's going to a school, or, you know, becoming that doctor or lawyer or architect or whatever you want to be, but you don't have that extra push. I want to be that for the younger generation.
I think that's really powerful too, because it's an inspiration.
Exactly.
And I know that, you know, first, how long did you work as a nurse before you decided to start your business?
8-9 years.
9 years. Yeah, because I know a lot of people that, you know, went to Millersville. They all love That Shuu Girl Boutique. Yes. Everybody I talk to is like, oh, yeah, I love that place.
Yeah, we have a lot of college students that come, F&M in Millersville, and the few girls that are at Thaddeus Stevens. So I do get a lot of support from the college students. And because we are in a prime location downtown, we get a lot of support from our neighbors and the law offices and the doctor's offices that are around us and the probation offices that are around us that come in and support That Shuu Girl Boutique.
Yeah,
and, you know, when you open a business, you get so scared and you're like, oh my gosh, who's going to support me? Who's going to come in? And then Lancaster is such a great small city and very supportive, and everyone loves to support one another, and that's what I love about Lancaster.
That's really important. I think that's what it comes down to. And I mean, when you start your own business like you, and you know, you don't have your other job anymore, you put it all on the line.
Yes.
So it is nerve-wracking.
Yes.
Like, I can't say that it's not. You know, you are putting everything on the line. This is what I want to do. So.
Oh, yeah. My grand opening, I was so scared. I told my fiance, I'm like, I don't think I want to do this. He was like, you're doing it. You have all your inventory. You already made the announcement. He was like, he's like my backbone. So he's like, you're doing this. And the day that we opened That Shuu Girl, our grand opening, it was pouring down raining. And I did not know that it was going to rain. It's supposed to be beautiful that whole day. And we only opened from 6 to 9. And our store was jam-packed. That's when I knew, that moment, when most of our stuff was sold out, we just had like a few pieces on the rack, our store was jam-packed, it was thunderstorming. I'm like, I know, God is telling me this is what I'm supposed to do. So it was just a blessing from day one.
You know, you're doing something right when it's pouring out everyone's leaving their house and they all come in.
Oh, yeah.
Did the SPDC help you with the grand opening, or?
No.
Okay.
They did not. So when I first opened my business, my fiance and I did the research ourselves.
Okay.
We did not know about any loans. We didn't know about any grants or anything that was out there. I didn't go to school for business. I went to school to be a nurse. And just from that, like I said, I always knew I wanted to open a business. So I took that leap of faith and I opened my store, but I didn't know anything. I saved 100% of the money that I opened the store with, so I didn't get a loan. But throughout having my business and going to different meetings and networking and stuff like that, that's when I found out about a lot of the small programs that are there, and I actually met Keisha from SBA when I spoke at the Cultivate Lancaster.
Okay.
So that's how I met her, and that's how we got connected. And she's been mentoring me throughout my business. It's been about, I want to say, 2 years since I met Keisha, and she's been a really big mentor to me.
Keisha, yeah, she's great. She's actually my mentor as well. And so Keisha's been helping you, and now you're looking to expand.
Yes.
So how has Keisha been helping, SPDC been helping you do that? And tell us a little bit about the expansion itself.
Okay, so the first time I spoke with Keisha, she asked if I had a business plan. Well, first she asked me about my business, how I got started. So we spoke about that, and she asked me what I wanted to do in the future with my business. And I told her I wanted to expand. I want to open a few more stores. And so we spoke about that. She had me write up a business plan. She had me write up some financial stuff. And she looked at it and she was like, wow, I'm here for you. Let me know whatever you need me to do. I'm going to do it for you. So we've just been talking, and I've told her my goals and my plan and when I want to open these other stores, and it's happening. That's I'm opening my second location. It's a sister store of That Shuu Girl Boutique, so it's going to be called Nicole Taylor Boutique, and we're gearing towards the demographics that we are not targeting at That Shuu Girl. So it'll be a whole different demographic, so we're not competing against each other.
So it's a
It's different. We're still going to stick to American-made, local, and independent designers, and a lot of brands that give back. So that's what we want to stick with: sustainable. We want to stick with ethical. We want to stick with American-made, and we want to make sure that we showcase a lot of local designers. So
I just think, what's going to be the main difference though between this store? You know, it's going to be targeting a different demographic, but how?
So That Shuu Girl is more, the age range is, I would say, from like college to about 40, 45. That the Nicole Taylor Boutique is going to be geared towards more of your professional. We're going to have a lot of work attire there, and more geared towards that age range that we don't have at That Shuu Girl. So we're going to capture all of Lancaster, all pretty Lancaster. Much. All and of Lancaster close, and all different demographics.
How close are the stores to each other?
I would say, so it's going to be on Queen Street on a 300 block.
Okay.
So it, I would say it's a little distance
solid
from.
Solid wall.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Cool.
Yep.
So I follow you on social media.
Yes.
And you're posting all the time.
Yes.
So let's talk about some of your success through social media.
I take advantage of anything that's free.
Right.
Social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, any of those that are free. I think any small business should take advantage of that, because marketing gets expensive. You know, you have your marketing budget, and sometimes we past that, so we need to look at other resources, and social media has been amazing to me. We always do photo shoots, and we have one of my bloggers, Cora. She is one of our she's like the face of our Instagram and in Facebook, and Betsy, who is my employee, she's also another face of That Shuu Girl, where we take a day and we do photo shoots and to focus
so
on the new
back
stuff.
To like when you were younger, right?
Yeah, I love it.
And you do it right outside the store, right?
And we do it right outside the store. So Cora, like I said, she's our blogger for our website, and she puts the outfits together. She has amazing style. So she's the one who puts the outfits together for our blog and for all of our social media. And then I style Betsy, which I love. I just love styling.
And you keep it relevant too, right? You had a couple of weeks ago? Lancaster was popping. There's like you had a red carpet fashion show.
Yes, that's what That Shuu Girl is known for. We do fashion shows, and we love doing fashion shows, and we love to step outside of the box. So I get a lot of girls from the community who always wanted to model. So we love to give women chances and young girls chances. So I post on our social media, hey, looking for models. And a lot of the girls inbox me and they're like, well, I never modeled before, but it's always something that I wanted to do. I'm like, yes, you are the type that we want. We want to help you, you know, get out there, make you feel comfortable and show yourself
just
off.
Like another,
you
know,
way of giving back. So the last one that we had was Fortin Brow, who has Lush Bazaar clothing, and we did a fashion show. It was Lush Bazaar meets That Shuu Girl. So we now carry her stuff in store, which is doing phenomenal. So we mix and match her pieces with our pieces, and we had Sarah, who does henna. So it was an Indian theme fashion show at their store because Tim Burrell is Indian and so is Sarah.
Okay, so yeah, cool. So it's like you're just collaborating.
We're just collaborating and we love working with our community and giving back. So we don't get any professional models for that. We get girls from our community to model our clothing.
So just another way, it's locally sourced, American made.
Exactly.
The people who are advertising it are from the area, so
yes.
It's just another, that's helped build the self-esteem. It like goes back to like mentoring and self-esteem.
Yeah.
I think is something that holds a lot of people back to begin
with.
So
exactly.
Just a little push sometimes can make somebody's day turn around.
Yeah, and that's what we want to build women up. We want to let them know, hey, we're here for you. Doesn't matter if you're a plus size or a size zero. It doesn't matter. You are beautiful. So we want to make sure that we enhance that beauty in the women and let them know, you know, don't worry about it. You're beautiful. You don't need to be, you know, a certain size to be beautiful. You are beautiful the way you are. So that's what That Shuu Girl stands for. We want to make sure that we give you that inner beauty and the outer beauty.
The inner and outer beauty.
Yes.
Well, I think that's perfect.
Yeah.
So I just want to thank Nicole for coming out because I think
you.
That was a perfect line to close on.
Thank you.
And I want to thank BCTV.org for having us. Thank you.